Good evening, I'm Riza Diaz. This is One News Now. Bikes continue to be a hot commodity as the metro enters the second week of GCQ. Now, workers are flocking Quezon Boulevard in Quiapo to look for the best deal, but shop owners say stocks are running low. So let's get the rest of that story from Lynn Olivario.
Ace Advent has experienced walking from Blumentritt to Tutuban to clean the appliance store where he's working at during the quarantine. He says it demanded a lot of energy and it took him 45 minutes to get to the shop. So when the store finally opens and work resumes, he'll be riding his mini mountain bike that he bought for 4,500 pesos.
Nakad lang eh, pero no choice eh, kasi malayuan na rin ho yung ano eh, nakapagod na rin ho. Bukod sa trabaho ma'am, kasi sa trabaho namin hanggang tatlong araw lang ho pasok eh. Magsa-sideline na lang po ng paghatid ng pagkain, mga ganun ho.
Jolo de la Cruz, a security agency personnel, is allotting 7,000 pesos to find a bike that he can use as a daily grinder.
Kahit na medyo mahal po siya, basta sigurado po yung piyesa na hindi madaling masisira. Kasi pag bumili tayo ng mumura eh, at second hand, hindi tayo sigurado, wala tayong warranty. Kaya mas maganda pumunta tayo sa mga shop para sa warranty. And then sa sigurado po tayo na brand new po yung item na makukuha natin.
They are just among the many buyers scouting the stores here along Quezon Boulevard in Quiapo, Manila. Bike dealers say demand since the start of the ECQ has beat their holiday sales. But now, stocks are running low.
Dati ma'am, maramihan talaga kami kumuha ng bike, sangat dati. Pero sa ngayon ma'am, pag kumuha kami sa supplier, nasa 20 to 30 units na lang po makukuha. Sa isang linggo ma'am, sa isang supplier, mga 20, 30, hindi kagaya dati, tig 100 units ang makukuha ng isang truck namin. Dati ma'am, madalas ma'am sa isang week, 4 times ma'am, ngayon 1 beses lang ma'am, minsan hindi pa, after 2 weeks pa po ma'am.
Bike dealer Clark Zapiti no longer accommodates wholesalers because of his dwindling stocks.
Kami, binibigay namin is, pinapriority namin is yung may mga trabaho. Kasi ngayon, sa yung nangyayari kasi ngayon is yung iba, nag-wholesale, so hindi namin pinapriority pag wholesale. Dapat retail lang. So at least one person per bike kami. O one bike per person lang, benta namin. Ngayon. Oh, para lahat meron. So lahat makakabili ng bike, walang mauubusan. Tinatanong po namin kung saan nagtatrabaho, kung saan gagamitin. Kasi doon na malalaman kung bebentahan namin ng bike yung certain person.
Fewer stocks also means slightly higher prices. Although Clark Zapatin retained prices of most items, some brands are more expensive by as much as 500 pesos. Folding bikes now cost anywhere between 4,500 and 8,000 pesos, depending on the material, if it's steel or alloy. Mountain bikes cost 6,000 to 7,000 pesos. In another store, bikes priced between 5,000 to 7,000 pesos are running out. Some even bite the bullet and go for branded ones that could cost north of 20,000 pesos. For News 5, Lynn Olivario, We Are One News.
Now here are other stories we're keeping our eyes on. Former PCGG Chairman Attorney Camilo L. Sabio will face the Sandigan Bayan on Monday following his arrest by the NBI. Sabio has a number of graft charges pending before the court for alleged corruption during his 5-year chairmanship at the PCGG from 2005 to 2010. Baguio City Mayor Benji Magalo says no one, regardless of rank and position, is exempted from the city's health and safety protocols. Magalo's statement came after a group of visiting officials led by San Juan City Mayor Francis Zamora allegedly ignored the border control checkpoint and proceeded straight to their place of destination. And a South Korean boy band BTS donates $1 billion to support the human rights movement Black Lives Matter. On their Twitter account, the 7-member group condemned violence and racial discrimination. The movement encouraged fans to call for more donations under the hashtag #MatchAMillion. Now for more updates, follow News 5, The Philippine Star, and Business World Online. I'm Riza Diaz. We are One News.